You've just finished your hardware and wiring installation, and you're getting a little bit closer to starting up that engine for the first time. But before you do that, you need to load a global file to your ECU. The example I'm going to use today is just going to be a basic street naturally aspirated 454 Chevrolet with a Holley intake and throttle body. It's going to be multi-port, and I want to do timing control, so I'm going to use an MSD 8366 small cap timing control HEI. Let's take a look at the software, and I'll show you how to load that global file, as well as making a few initial changes to the configurations in there to match my combination. Reviewing the options that were described in the base calibration information section that I read in the help files, I chose to go with an MPI 48BB225HE global file because this looks like a pretty good starting point for my application. To load this file, I'll start by clicking File, then Open Global File. In the global file directory, I'm going to select base cals and click on the MPI 48BB225HE base file. You should always read and understand any information provided in the pop-up notifications. In this case, the crank sensor inductive delay warning pops up. This is going to pertain to certain types of ignition control. For now, I'm just going to go ahead and close this one out. You should see the global file name selected appear in the top left corner of your screen. Since I don't want to corrupt my base file, I'm going to save it as a different file name by clicking on File and Save Global File As. I can change the directory location if I want, but I'm just going to save it to my base calibrations folder by changing the file name. I think I'm just going to call this one New 454 Base and select Save. You should see the new file name in the top left corner of your screen. Next, you will want to check a few parameters as they may require some changes from the base calibration. Click on the system icon at the top of your screen and select Engine Parameters tab. Following this step-by-step beginner's tuning guide, make sure that all the displayed settings are going to be correct for your application. It's important to remember to select the proper O2 sensor, whether using a Bosch or an NTK sensor, before you plug the sensor into the main engine harness, otherwise you're going to damage that sensor. Depending on your ECU, you can run one or two O2 sensors for active fuel management. The HP will do one and the dominator will do two. Since my plan is to run a dominator ECU, I've chosen to add a second wideband sensor to my right-hand bank using a 558-401 auxiliary harness and picking up an additional 554-100 NTK O2 sensor. You can then select how the ECU uses the information from the second wideband sensor. For now, I'm going to go ahead and choose average and let it average out the left and right bank. I now need to change my injector specifications to reflect my 42 lb/hour Holley injector set. Since I know I'll be running a regulated fuel pressure of 58 psi, I'll need to change my actual system pressure setting to 58 psi. I also want to run my injectors in a bank-to-bank injector configuration, so I'll change that now. Next, I want to make sure that my ignition type is correct. By selecting the ignition tab, you can select from several common ignition types, as well as set up a variety of custom configurations. In my case, since I'm going to run an MSD 8366 computer-controlled HEI, I'm going to select GM HEI computer-controlled. Please be aware that this setting is for timing control HEI distributors only, and it will not work with large cap vacuum advanced HEIs. If you've got a large cap HEI, you need to go ahead and select coil inductive coil only, no timing control. At this point, I've edited the minimum amount of parameters required for base calibration, and I want to save these changes by clicking on the Save tab at the top of the screen. Now I need to send this file to the ECU. Make sure that the ECU is properly wired and then connect the USB cable from the ECU to the laptop. The first time you connect the ECU to your PC, it may take a moment for your PC to recognize the ECU and load the drivers. If this occurs, just pause a moment and let your PC do its thing. The communication status will change from offline to USB link. Turn the ignition to run, make sure you don't go to crank, and then click the USB link. The software is going to go through and compare to the existing files on the ECU to the global folder you're trying to load. If things don't match, it'll show fail and give you an option to either get from or send to ECU. Since we want to upload this new file, we're going to go ahead and click send to ECU to upload that new global file. We'll then confirm that the file has been uploaded to the ECU and that they now match and pass. This screen will close out after about 5 seconds. Your communication status will now show online. Congratulations, you're one step closer to starting your engine. Next, you'll need to perform a TPS auto set and run through some pre-startup checks. To find out how and to view more helpful Holley EFI Tech videos, go to holley.com.